Nasa loob po ako ngayon ng growing pond dome ng CP Foods Philippines. Ang CP Foods Philippines actually ay isang multinational. Subalit pumasok sila sa shrimp, white shrimp production sa Pilipinas sapagkat nakita nila ang potential ng industriya na ito. And through their technology, ito pong technology na ito, itong white shrimp production ay lumalaganap sa buong Mindanao. And we have the ideal climate. Walang bagyo halos at saka napakalinis ng tubig, no? So ngayon, nandito po ako sa loob ng isang dome ng CP Food Philippines dito sa Hagonoy, Davao del Sur. Isa sa mga areas na kung saan gumawa ng malaking investment ang CP Food Philippines. And we are here because there is a group of Filipino investors who would like to venture into this very profitable agricultural, aquaculture industry. Sabi nila, 2,000 square meters. Ito, 2,000 square meters lang. Pero ang kikitain mo dito, 2.4 million in 75 days. In 75 days. Siguro mga net, mga 1 million. Ganyan po kayaman ng Mindanao. This is the beauty and bounty of Mindanao. Ayan po, sample. 25 grams of shrimp. At dahil nga sa COVID ay naglalakihan na. Kailangan nilang maibenta na. At napakamura ngayon ng presyo. Pero pagkatapos ng COVID, babalik yung presyo, kikita na malaki. Ito po si Marjun Villanueva, Assistant Vice President ng CP Food Philippines.
Yes, Secretary.
For Sales and Marketing. He will explain to us the inside story of this facility that CP Food Philippines established in Hagonoy, Davao del Sur. Paano kayo nagpunta dito? How did you discover this place?
Actually, we started here, Secretary, the year of 2015, no, around April. CP was already actually searching for an area that time because we have our shrimp farms already in Luzon, in Zambales, but they know that Mindanao has the best climate, no? Especially we are not visited by typhoon. They always have problems of typhoon every year in Luzon, so they worry about that. So they are searching for a new investment in the south, which is in Mindanao. So we have located this area. This is actually under Toto Inying Diriquito.
Nilis nyo lang?
Yes po, we leased the land for 20 years. And then we started developing it. Latest technology that we have in Thailand, no, we transferred here. Not only for shrimp production, but this is like our showroom. Kung ano yung mga latest technology ng shrimp farming in other countries, especially with the CP, we transferred it here for our farmers.
So ano palawak tong area na ito?
This is 100 hectares, okay. Total area. And now,
how many tons do you produce?
Actually, we have a target of 800 metric tons per year. 800. And we are close to that.
800 million kilos?
Yes po, 800 okay. million kilos.
Magkano ang kilo ngayon ang benta nyo?
Now, because of the situation with COVID-19, now it's not easy for us to bring our produce in Manila because 90% of our produce we have to bring sa Manila. We have export here in Jensan, we have exporters, but very limited. So now the price dropped from 250 pesos 10 grams, now it came down to 170.
Okay.
So almost 80 pesos down compared to the real price mm-hmm. before, original price.
Okay. Ordinarily, magkano?
It's that size, Secretary, 20 grams, it's 300 pesos per kilo.
Wow.
Yes.
So kung ako si farmer, may isang hektarya ako na ganito ang setup, magkano kikitain ko?
Based on our results and our calculation, you should always get an ROI of a minimum of 40%. No? The biggest in any industry, you get 1 million pesos for every hectare.
Wow.
Yes. For 100 days.
100 days. 3 months and a half.
That is because
Pero
of our...
capital intensive nito, no?
We can say that for every 2 million investment, then you have to get a net profit of 1 million.
Okay.
So you
so
need...
So, bali one-third ang
yes,
ROI
yes, yes.
mo. Okay. Kung ako, halimbawa, interesado ako, how can I ask CP Philippines to help me?
Yeah, actually, sir, we have our staff all over Mindanao and every region because that is also our aim is to really help the farmers transfer of technology, because that's the aim. Once the farmers get the good result, it will also come back to us by buying our fry and our feeds. Mm-hmm. So we give them the technical support.
All right. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So ngayon, hindi mo ma-saturate ang market kapag biglang bumulto yung banami sa Mindanao?
Based also in my experience, sir, actually we are still a baby, no, compared to other countries like Indonesia. Our 60,000 metric tons a year production is still very small based on the demand in Luzon. Uh-huh. Because now...
So yun ang national output natin ngayon?
Yes, nabota sa Malabon, 60,000 metric tons.
Metric tons.
Yes, sir.
For the whole Philippines?
Yes, yes, yes. Sir.
Okay. So anong estimated consumption ng Pilipinas?
We are saying that the saturation will be 100,000, but I think by that time also again, you know, income will increase, population will increase, so it will just commensurate to that.
So you're encouraging farmers now invest in banana production.
I think
challenges, anong mga problema?
Like other agriculture, no, we also have, I think main problem is disease. We have the technology, we have the our brood stock, no, the source of our fry is pathogen free. We import it from Thailand, mm-hmm. and we bring it check by BFAR to ensure that there's no disease. So the fry is already free of disease. Next to that will be management, of course. Okay. That's why we are there to teach the farmers how to mitigate that disease problem.
So karamihan ng mga technical people niyo, mga Thailander?
Mix of Filipinos and Thailander.
Yung transfer of technology, paano?
Every week, we visit our farmers and we teach them from stocking until harvest.
For the whole of Mindanao, ilang hektarya na meron ng banami product?
We have now, based on our profile, 1,000 hectares.
1,000 hectares?
Yes, sir.
So we can expand?
Of course, sir.
Okay.
We have the best in the Philippines, climate and everything.
Very good. Mark. Kaharap po natin ngayon si Elaine Vera Belvis, Regional Fisheries Officer ng Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. Elaine, ano ang tulong ng gobyerno, anong tulong ng BFAR specifically for investments in banamay production?
Specifically for shrimp banamay, penis banamay, one of the requirements of the BFAR is to register existing grow-out farms, particularly in order to monitor them, sir, po, kung compliant ba sila with the biosecurity procedures.
Okay, so biosecurity?
Yes po, yes
right.
po.
Meron ba tayong mga incentives sa kanila?
One of the incentives is the part of our monitoring.
Uh-huh.
For the disease surveillance po, sir.
Disease surveillance.
So every year we conducted monitoring. We collect samples on site on the farm, and then we detect, we diagnose for shrimp diseases.
Okay.
Particularly.
Halimbawa ako, OFW, may grupo kami. Gusto namin mag-invest sa banamay. Ano ang kailangan namin kunin sa BFAR?
So, initially, one is you have to register your farm as a requirement. You have to have your business permit. And then you have to comply the biosecurity procedures. And then inspection will follow thereafter to check if suitable po ba yung area na paglalagyan and in place po yung biosecurity procedures.
Bali advisory kayo?
Yes po, on
so
technical
you
matters.
So you protect the interest of our investors?
Yes po.
Okay, very good. So thank you, Elaine. And
thank
please
you.
Extend my thanks to your director.
Yes, Secretary. Thank you.
Boots Cordora, presidente ng FinTech
Aqua Ventures.
Nagkaplano kayong magtayo ng ganitong facility. Yung inyo is 90 hectares. What made you decide to venture into this activity?
Actually, we want to be part of the government and also to help government program into their livelihood program. So,
may area na kayo? Katabi na itong area na ito?
Katabi ng area na ito, meron na tayo.
90 hectares yung sa inyo?
Yeah, it's a
but,
90 hectares.
I know that aside from your banamay project, you are also looking into fish cage farming.
Yes, because aside from banamay, we'll also be into bangus production, milk fish.
Milk fish production.
Yeah, yeah.
Who convinced you to go into bangus production and what convinced you?
It's actually on the direction of food security of the government. We want to be part of the government program in that aspect and have a social impact in our community.
Okay. So good luck to your project.
Thank you.
Hope
yes,
that you succeed.
Thank you very much.
Nasa likod ko po ngayon, itong 100-hectare area ng Vanamay Production ng CP Foods Philippines. Isa po sa mga malalaking kumpanya, multinational, based in Thailand. It's Thailand's biggest agricultural and aquaculture corporation. At nag-branch out sila sa Mindanao kasi nakita nila yung potential ng Mindanao sa food production area. But in contrast to our local farmers, they brought in with them their investments, their technology, which happily they are sharing right now with our people in Mindanao. Ang sabi nila, maganda sa Mindanao, walang bagyo, malinis ang tubig, at unti-unti nang lumalaganap ang kapayapaan sa dati magugulong lugar. So mga kaibigan, ito po ang Mindanao ngayon. And I am happy as chairman of the Mindanao Development Authority under the office of the president na nakikita natin ang pagbabago ng Mindanao sa ilalim ng pamumuno ng ating Pangulong Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Sa ngalan po ng Mindanao Development Authority, ako po si Secretary Manny Piñol at nagsasabing, come, discover the beauty and bounty of Mindanao.